afternoon. Please save in the right file. Oh, thank goodness it saved the right file. So during this stage, the schematic stage, I really want you guys to like sort of level up your site planning. I'm sure other teachers have told you this, but they didn't really highlight it. Like when you introduce your concept for the design, don't think about just, what do you call this, just your site and the boundaries within your site. Because this is what I noticed, especially sa atuang, our class specifically, and sort of previous years as well, like incoming the previous third years, when they do their site planning, they just look at this, the shaded area, and they don't think about Bayfront, SM City, Radisson, blah, 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 or just the road around those areas. Like, what are the kinds of people in Bayfront Hotel? What kinds of people are going to Radisson Hotel? And what kinds of people are coming in SM Cebu City? And then obviously there's like a few people walking by this area. And then it's even more important, especially because we highlighted it in the design problem. Now, our goal is really number one, accessibility. So to improve your accessibility in your design, think about where are the people coming from? And we really need to move away from this vehicle-centric design. The things we see in Cebu, especially the way parking and cars are handled, is really something we should move away from. I can't think of a good example off the top of my head, and we tried looking for one earlier in the session, and my brain is fried. I can't seem to remember anything. Anyway, in terms of accessibility, I'll just call it A, or access. This is really your best bet for a like an entrance for the people or for pedestrians. So there's an SM entrance here. There's another SM entrance here. And just distance-wise, this is really the closest. So one sort of big thing to make an entrance for pedestrians, to make it as close as possible to other entrances of nearby buildings. Bayfront Hotel definitely has like some people coming in it. So this could be another possible entrance, but like the higher number of people is really SM. Radisson Blue, this area here is a sort of perimeter wall, so there's no access. And then on the, what they call this, highway side, the Sergio Smenya Boulevard, there's no people here. It's like freight, sort of industrial area. So your priority pedestrian access is here on the, Where is north? North is down here. Okay. Is that right? Okay. According to Google Maps, north is here, but I could be reading it wrong, just in case. And then this is your priority entrance one, and this is your priority entrance two for pedestrians. Okay. And once you establish that, this is your pedestrian entrance here, pedestrian entrance here. Then you can start designing your vehicle entrance. Okay. So Natalie proposed vehicle entrance to turn here and then exit somewhere here or like somewhere here. I think that's okay.
Officer.
Yep.
It doesn't exit there, sir.
Okay. So.
Sorry. Can I share my screen real quick?
Oh, no, I have it here.
Okay, what is this
one?
Oh, that's for the second, the one on the left, sir. It doesn't exit to the 12 meter access. No, sir.
Okay.
For the buses, sir.
Okay. And that's okay. That's not a big problem. So put it to exit here. For me, I would really want to avoid entrance and exits near the corners of things. So this one is a bit too near for me, even with the 15 meter setback. Mostly because corners are really the areas where like cars and vehicles slow down to make a turn. And while you're driving, you need like to confirm that no one is coming in here. No one is like in front of you, or like no one will sideswipe you. So vehicles tend to slow down in these areas, in the corners. So if you put your entrance here, even if it's like 10 meters away, 15 meters away, 20 meters away, I think a good sort of distance would really be measure distance. Where is 30? 30 would be good. But like, because the site is about 120 meters, I would really just put it in the center to avoid all of that like collision or like slowing down in this corner over here. And currently the SM bus terminal has the main entrance here, which is functional, but I don't think is very good because this tends to be like, this tends to be congested during peak hours, this highway over here. So to like make the congestion less, the Kaohsiung, let me see. The Kaohsiung Street is really the sort of best entrance and exit for the bus terminal. And just like my own sort of personal preference based on my experience, it's really a lot better to have your, what do you call this, bus entrance and exit in the center. So you can have an entrance here, and you can have entrance here. Let me see. So your priority bus entrance for me, this is just for everyone, is here in Kaohsiung Road, Kaohsiung Street. And then another priority entrance exit will be here in the SM Street. And why? Because there's really not much traffic going on here. It's people coming into SM, and there's really not a lot of congestion. And this is a two-way road. And just to make sure, okay, the way the road is set up is that there's an we're right lane drive, so entrance is here and an exit is like that. So it makes sense now because we're right lane drive. If you make the exit here, it will go this way. And if you make the exit here, it would go this way while the entrance would go like that.
Sir? Yep. Sir, I know, like, when I was going through the mall, ba, I found something like, I don't know if it'll affect naman, pero it's actually the opposite, sir, for the access road, sir.
Kapalis, like,
ang pagsud nila, sir. Yeah.
Wait, hang on. Wait. Oh, balig yun siya.
Yeah. And it's kind of weird, sir, kay on the right, mananta siya sa... So Murag, they go through the left side, sir. Even if they
it's even yeah.
So when I tried to like not touch much on that, sir. But think, okay, is it okay, sir?
I think we can fix this actually. I don't know why they do this. To me that's really, really strange. Yeah, let's fix this entrance. Make it the actual entrance. I don't know why SM did this. Probably because there's no one coming in here. This road is almost always empty every time I drive by it. So we can say, oh, this is like the bus terminal, my bus like in construction. But yeah, we can change that because that doesn't make sense. I don't know why SM did that. Okay, so you have your priority. I'll just priority one and priority two. So when you're making your concept on accessibility, you need to really identify where are the best entrance and exits. Number one for the people and then the vehicles. Okay, so now we have our entrance and exits. So as stated by Natalie earlier, the 45 degree bus parking is good. It's better for the bus because they don't have to turn as much. But the thing with this setup here is this will work only if you're coming in here. Let me zoom in a bit more. They park like this, they reverse and then go out like this. Is this your intention here?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so that one is good. That's a correct parking there. So the same for here, backing and then go out like that. My only issue with this one is that if you're doing this, why not just exit out here? So you can use this part for like extra like space for whatever you need. So this one, having it like using so much sort of road in your site plan, just use the minimal amount. Don't use so much road. This one over here is a little bit better because it's more concentrated. I just don't like the fact that it's commingling with the private parking. And I think you can cut that private parking in half or if you need to, like depending on how your design goes through. So I'm not going to tell you a concept. I'm just going to follow the thing in the design problem. And you can add your own concepts, like some innovations, like, I don't know exactly, like whatever you can find, whatever you want to develop. Future expansion. Okay. So we address accessibility. So the path for the vehicles will most likely look like this. And the path for the people will be like this, I guess. Because let me start with the people again. They can come in here. They can go to the bus terminal over there. They can go to the bus terminal over here. They can go to the bus terminal over there. So you have a lot of space to work with. So it really depends where you want your bus terminal to be. How do you arrange your buses? So if your buses are arranged somewhere here, so the bus terminal will be here, bus terminal. So yeah, all of this space you can develop. So this could be a potential parking area over here, and this could also be a potential parking area over here. And then the 20 buses limit is there, so you don't like sort of fill up your space with kanang roads. So you can really like focus on the people. Okay, those in my urban planning or urban design class really know how much I want to emphasize that we need to design for people. Okay, just close that. So future expansion, you can have what they call this one row of building like this, or one building like this. It really depends on where you put your bus road. So if, for example, my bus road is like this, then this area over here, I'll just color it in blue, will have no room for expansion because it's blocked by the road. In this sort of scenario, the building, the area with the most expansion would be here on the left in the red. I think I'll just use another color. Let's see here. Pink. Okay. So your bus could be like a bus terminal, could be like this long, and then it could expand onto here. So that's for future expansion. Next, multimodal. This just makes sense. Make sure na conflict-free. So this is what nasangit ko si mong design, Natalie, because it seems like may conflict in both schemes. I think more it's a kanina scheme on the left, because there's a conflict between the vehicle parking, the private cars, and the buses over here, because they're using the same entrance and exit. Here, not so much. You can just fix this by having the private vehicles enter here and go out here, and then you don't sort of mingle them with the bus movement. So I think this one has better, what do you call this? What did Sir Shi call it? A multimodal sort of system. So this is less conflict.
Okay, sir.
Okay, less conflict. Sorry, I'll give an example because you're the one who came first. It'll be useful for you, but yep.
Do I still have to keep it there, sir? Or do I need to like take maybe like just put half of it? Kaya you said no need naman for the jeepneys and like parking for cars and motorcycles.
Yep. So for me, I don't think you need these. I would rather you have like more spaces for people, like stuff that people can use, like concession spaces or like just green open space. Because let me see here, where is it? If you look at the site again, I already have it here. If you look at the site here, this is not accessible because it's like private property. You go And actually, I don't think it's there anymore because it's being used for this building. Sort of at this scale, this is, I guess, like when you do your site analysis, what I was trying to say earlier is that you don't look at just your block over here. You sort of zoom out to see the other blocks around it. And then when you look at the other blocks around your site, there really is no green open space. Parks, public parks, sort of like a plaza, which we'll be discussing in my urban design class. I think I also share those videos. You can access it on YouTube. There's really no public space in Cebu. It's all semi-private. Like as I mentioned before in my other class, that I think the most successful public space in Cebu is really semi-private. It's owned by Ayala, and that's Ayala Terraces. You can also read about that in Natawan, sorry, in a plug puko. But yeah, anyway, it's very important to have green open space. And in this area, there's none. So with sort of my scheme here, you are free to copy it. I would like be interested to see how you develop it like this. The best location for the green open space would probably be here, because you can't already, you can't expand anymore. And then it's, what they call this. It could be a good waiting area for people like who come in here, or it could also be a sort of a nice artificial vista for your bus terminal. Because currently, let me color the vistas in orange. Like if your building is this purple blob here, pink blob, there's really nothing to look at like anywhere on the side. You can look at the wall of Radisson Blue over here. This is the wall of Radisson Blue. You have a view of the parking lot of SM, the industrial site, and maybe the hotel. So not really attractive view. So this could be, you could create your own views here. So this could be a purpose for your open space. And that will fit with the next issue over here, universal design. So I skipped passenger safety because I think that already goes without saying that. Make sure that you have elevated crosswalks, make sure people are seen, make sure there are no blind spots for your buses. The safety group really did a good job on this. And then integrating sustainable development and design. So, as we all know, we just experienced sort of Typhoon Agaton, and a lot of areas in the, I think not so much Cebu. Has anyone in our class experienced flooding in their areas? Of the 14 people that are here. Did you guys experience any flooding during the heavy rains we've had for the past week? Nan samua, okay. So far, nan sa tong class. I guess the other half, those who are not here, are the ones experiencing the flood. Okay. Anyway, so the advantage of having a large open park like this, it could also serve as a detention pond. So we have all gone through the school plate. And in the University of San Carlos, it has a detention pond, which also functions as the soccer field. So San Carlos University Talamban campus. And then I'm sure you all remember where the detention ponds are in the campus. So there's one over here, that's the soccer field. And there's a sort of a row of detention ponds coming in from the library all the way down to the gym. So knowing that, and then especially SM is very prone to flood. SM flooding. That's SM Sucat, SM Cebu. There were some major floods in 2015. So if you look at this video here, just moving. So that's SM. This is the bus terminal, like more to the, where's SM? I keep closing my tabs, I hate it. Let's go SM City Cebu. So this bus terminal is, oops. Where am I? I need to orient myself. The bus terminal is here at One Luna Avenue. And this is what we're seeing here. So already the access for Lucy, that's about knee high, I think, or a little bit over knee high. Ankle, definitely ankle height, yep. At the deepest part, probably knee high. So that is the One Luna Avenue. So let's see if there's any other flooding on the other side. So this is mostly the One Luna Avenue. Okay. Okay, but anyway, the point is this area is prone to flooding. I think there's some other images here. So this is exactly the corner near our bus terminal. Oh no, This is the right side of the, okay, that's probably on this side here, by Kaohsiung Road. I'm just basing it off the image. Let's open this. And here is, okay, this is much better. Blah, blah, blah. This page is not working, unfortunately. Not available right now. Anyway, so you see this is where the bus terminal currently is, and you see the flooding over there, and et cetera, et cetera. So the open park will be very useful, not just like as a gathering space to make your terminal more memorable and more like user-friendly. It's also will probably help with the flooding in the area. And you could also maybe upgrade the utilities in this area. Maybe you can have more open space over here. Natalie has a buffer area, I think. Yes. So this buffer area will be very useful in this scheme. Not so much this scheme. So very long answer to your question. I think this scheme is better than the scheme here, the scheme on the left. So I'll call the scheme one. I don't know which one is scheme one. But this scheme two is, for me, a lot better already. So develop scheme two. But before you do, just like develop the sort of the foundation of your concept. Like, what is your goal? How does it fit into the five goals stated in the design problem? Passenger safety is, like, I think the easiest one. So accessibility is a bit tricky because I think we should really need to highlight when we talk about accessibility, like internationally, it's really about the people and not the vehicles. Because if you go to Netherlands, Europe, even some parts in Asia, Japan, I think even also Indonesia is like moving towards more people-centric designs. Australia is also, I think, moving in that direction. It's just the US and former US colonies who are like stuck on like this like focus on vehicles. Even some countries, not some countries, some states in the US are adapting more universal design principles, basically accessibility principles. And we should really start moving away from thinking about vehicles first, because I know most of us are used to it, because like that's how we get around in Cebu, because the planning in Cebu is probably 50 years old, and like all the buildings, all the city planning is based around vehicle traffic. But slowly we're going to move away from that. So by the time you graduate, you'll be more sort of in line with what's actually happening in the industry and the profession. So again, I can't stress it enough. Think about your pedestrians first and then your vehicles second. Okay. So I ended up with this kind of scheme. So to recap, I started off with locating the pedestrian entrances in red. That's over here. The most sort of convenient or most competitive pedestrian entrance is up here, mostly because of the walking distance required from SM entrances. And why are we focusing on SM? Because it has the most number of visitors and people. So most likely, a lot of people dropping by SM will use our bus terminal. And then most likely, most of the people using the bus terminal work in SM. So it makes sense that we cater to them. Bayfront Hotel and like the hotels in this Kaohsiung Street would be our secondary target. Mostly because they are lesser in number, and most likely they won't need the bus terminal because they're in a hotel. They're probably like can't afford their own vehicle, so they don't need that. But it could also happen. The people in the Bayfront Hotel want to like travel to the north of Cebu City for some reason, so we'll provide access for them. Then we discuss which one of the three roads would be best for vehicle entrance and exit. And number one priority is Kaohsiung Street because it's very sort of light in traffic. And the location would be, if possible, near the center of the lot to reduce like congestion in the corners. Because as I stated earlier, the corners is where vehicles slow down to make sure they turn properly and not hit other vehicles. So you would want to avoid entrance and exit at the corner. So I said the same thing in the hospital, the hotel. And then sort of the secondary location for entrance and exit would be the SM Street. I'll just call it the SM Street. And then feel free to correct the weird vehicle layout for SM. For some reason, they are driving on the wrong side. It just goes to show you how bad the situation is. And then it also indicates that this road, the Kaohsiung Street, really doesn't have a lot of traffic because they were able to get away with this and like nobody seems to be complaining. Now we're driving in the wrong side. This is like European style over here. It's left-hand drive, but our vehicles are right-hand drive. Anyway, okay. Then once we identified that, we located a good where our building should be, just based on the context of the site. For me, the best location for the building would be near the highway over here, mostly because our vehicle sort of traffic, our entrances and exits, cause this sort of pathway here in yellow, and that prevents future expansion. So if we put the building here in the blue and green area, it's kind of lacking space for future expansion. So if we put it to the left side on the screen over here, near Sergio Smeña Boulevard, we would have more space for expansion because we're not sort of tied down by the movement of the vehicles. And then this area here would also be accessible for the pedestrians as well, easier access. If we put it here in the green and blue, another like reason why we don't put our building there is that they have to cross the bus terminal road, like in yellow. So once you locate your vehicle entrance and exit, then it's very easy for you to determine your building, where your building should be. And then because we don't have our building here, this area in green and blue would be the best location for like an open park. And then we can even have like additional access to the park from here. I'll just change the color to light green, yellow green. This could be a good access to the public park over here. And then you could also maybe connect it to the building like this. And then you can have some kind of like axial arrangement. And you could put like some kind of like monument here, fountain, whatever, to make your garden open park area more memorable and more picturesque. Otherwise, maybe you could put your building up here and then you can make your access like that. Okay. So
I have a quick question, sir. The drawing you have now, sir, it's kind of similar to my first scheme, sir. So
It does look like your first scheme. The issue here is that any conflict is really like standing out to me.
Okay, sir. Can I share my screen real quick, sir?
Mm-hmm. Yes, go ahead. Let me do.
Sorry, sir. Galipog lang ko, sir. Kaya like, it kind of looks like my first scheme, sir. Pero like,
yeah, it really does.
Mas prefer ni mo niya. Sir, what if, sir, kay, if example, sir, I follow katong imong suggestion, sir. So I move the entrance and exit to the middle, sir. And then the building, I'll also move it as well, and I'll probably take this out, sir.
Yeah, you could take that out, or you can lessen it. How will they access the garage? They have to like make a U-turn there now to get to the garage.
I think I will change that, sir, because you said man ka, sir, na like no need na for the parking. So I think
we can move that closer here, so it's more fun. Easier access.
Sir. So maybe I can put it somewhere here, siguro, sir. Like around here. I'm not quite sure yet.
Mm-hmm.
And maybe like move this entrance here towards the middle. Is that okay, sir?
Yep. And then the drop off area has to go.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, because we don't have the kuanana. You can, let me see here. For this specific scheme, what was really missing was the pedestrian access.
Mm-mm.
That's why I opted more for the first one and the conflict between the vehicle. Anyway, if you remove the private vehicle and jeepney parking, it would flow much better. And mm-hmm. then just change the 90-degree to 45-degree parking slots.
Like
a thinner road there. And yes, then sir. The drop-off area will be, I think, much better if you put it to SM the side.
Okay. Oh, sir. I tried another solution, sir.
Hmm.
Which is like legit, just like mirror lang, sir. So let's just disregard na lang, siguro, sir. This area, this thing. Let's say wala siya dira, because apparently you don't need it. But what I did was I mirrored it, sir. Tapos I think it gives better pedestrian access, because the reason why like, it's actually like I don't know the word, but it's parallel to like the access road. So I think it does give better, it does satisfy katong imong giingon sir na pedestrian.
So this is a good setup too. So this is really what design is about. Like we keep on drawing. Sometimes the original plan is better than the next plan. So just really taking note of all the advantages. So this one, just mirroring it, the building, the terminal building is closer to SM, which is good.
Well, the bus entrance and exit as well, sir. Kay, it's not it's not abrupt. It's not on the corner na. But I think I can just edit this part at the back, sir, and like maybe like move this entire building towards the back, siguro, sir, somewhere there, just to close it off also for future building expansions also.
I think you don't need to do that because this already looks pretty good like this. The future expansion would be if you add, like, for example, I'll leave it there, zoom out. So if you move it back, you won't have room for future expansion. I'll call it Scheme 3 Bus Terminal. Sorry, I'm monopolizing Natalie ang session, but
I'm it's so sorry.
Advantage for Kuan coming in first come, first serve. I'll leave like 1 hour for everyone else. So anyway. This is the early bird gets the worm. Anyway, so this is the terminal here. The building itself looks kind of slender, but it's okay. You can develop it further. If you move this here, like Anisha.
Oh, sir, you're not sharing your screen.
Oh, sorry. Sorry. I'm already like, I'm in the zone. I'm awake. Okay, can you see?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so if we move this here like that, then you would increase your like road area and then you won't have any more room for expansion. So let me explain the scenario in my head when you said like you wanted to move this here. Control shift N. So this will be, I'm assuming road na, like that. And then maybe we'll increase imong park over here, something like that. So I'll just shade in the road. So this is your road. Okay, something like that. And this will be probably more bus spaces over here. So why do I think that Kenish and Indot is that you already have your terminal here and there's really no room for it to grow this way or this way because it's already like full. Meanwhile, if you just leave it like this, you can add new bus parking slots here like this. And then you can just leave this, before you add the new bus parking slots, you can leave this as like more open space. So I would prefer you not move the building. I just like call this, maybe do like a broken line thing, or like maybe something like that. Or you can have this as a park now, and then just call it like future expansion. Alternatively, but it would require more effort on the builder's part. If you move it like this up here, the sort of new buses would probably be, so many options here. Bro, this is one that stands out to me the most. You make your building like this, and then your road would be here. Your park would probably be increased as well, moving up here. And your bus slots would be like this. And this would be like that. And then maybe you would have another set of, like for future expansion would be something like this, bus slots like that. But then it will be disconnected from your building. So I would much rather keep it like this, and this will be your future expansion here in green.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
Also, sir, ang amount of bus parking slots, sir, it's just 20, sir. Or is it just like 20 active buses? Do we add like parking slots for idle buses?
For me, that's the 20 sort of everything na. How you divide it between arrival or departure is really up to you. But I would really keep it at 20. Okay, just to make it easier for you guys, you're not like super hago with the space.
Okay, sir.
You can add more if you want, but like this, for example, this is already pretty good, a pretty good start. Now, we could just make this 45 like this. So it's easier for the bus to park, go out, and then leave. And this will probably be like this. But the corner will be like an issue here. Like you can't put out there. Probably like you'll start somewhere. You'll limit until here, siguro. So pulling out here, then this will be an issue for me. Okay, this is like an entrance here, and you don't want your bus crossing that. You might want to remove a parking slot like that, so it will look like this. It won't look as symmetrical for it'll be more convenient for the buses. And then you can reduce this road over here, so you can have more open space over here. This drop-off area maybe could be something like this, or I would rather not have the drop-off area as well because it can just go directly to SM. But maybe something like this, something smaller, something like that. So you can have like
Oh, sir. By the way, sir, I followed the katong 3.5 radius for the drop-off area, sir.
3.5 radius, yeah. Just. That's for private vehicles, man, diba? Like cars.
Also, mga like jeepneys, or if ever like or taxis, like if ever they just want to utilize the open space, sir.
Because like they'll be coming in here. Like if your building is here, the drop-off area would be here instead, and not like in the open space. The drop-off area should be closer to the building, so I would remove this and put this somewhere here.
Sorry, sir. So I'll just take it out, long, sir.
Yeah, for me, I'd rather take it out. And really, this is me designing your building for you. So you need to add something else. else that makes it like your design without something on top of the five design goals. Like not really something new, bro. Like, what do you think is important in a bus terminal design? Like based on your research or whatever, based on your, which group were you in, Natalie?
Safety, sir.
Safety, like what other safety features could you put in here? Like for this one, the drop-off area here, especially if we're coming in this way, coming that way and go out this way, this is not very safe because there's incoming traffic from this way. There's also incoming traffic from this way. So it'd be very busy. It's not very safe for me. And then over here, I think this is pretty good. This one is pretty good. Just really missing that pedestrian access. What else? I think that's pretty much it.
See here. Sir, so basically, sir, kay, you prefer kanang the second and the third scheme, sir?
Basically, I think the third scheme is the best. The advantage of this scheme over here for everyone is that it's much easier for the buses to go in and out. Yeah, basic. But the disadvantage has two entrance and exits, one entrance and two exits. But this one is like very convenient for the bus, which comes at the price of it's not so convenient for the people. Another way you could like use this scheme over here, if anyone is curious. Now, this scheme, I like the fact that the best thing about this scheme is really the bus movement, and there's no conflict with the private vehicle movement over here. Like, because Natalie wanted like private vehicle parking. Another sort of thing that you could do, let me turn this off. Sort of looking at Natalie's scheme too, you can have the building over here, the bus terminal like this, although the entrance for the people is further away. So again, that's like that's what happens when you sort of prioritize vehicles first. So if you notice, if the entrance would be like somewhere here, they come in like something like this, I would still have my vehicle enter something like that. And you could exit here. You have like another set of vehicle entrances here, exit like that. And then this could be, notice na nawa na ko expansion space. I could make this open park, open park, open park, open park, but my building has no expansion space because of the road in yellow over here. And also notice that my pedestrian entrance over here is sort of intersected or in conflict with the vehicle entrance. So this area here, I just highlight in yellow green. This is what you want to avoid. Avoid any part of the pedestrian path and the vehicle path that they would like intersect. So this is not good. Maybe if that wasn't there and we just focus on this, something like this, your building will be here, your pedestrian access will be here, and then you can have your big park over here. You see here, this could be like future expansion as well. Oops, sorry. This will be future expansion for your building over here. And maybe, I don't know how the building will expand like this, because if you put your building in the middle like this, it kind of doesn't, can't expand that way. And then your road is basically just this. Oops, sorry. Your road is just basically, oops, PB. Your road is basically just this. So with this setup, this space up here, I'll just highlight it in yellow green. This one is not used so much, and there's like sort of no way for it to be accessed by the buses. So this will provide very good sort of an open park for the people coming into SM, but not much utility in terms of like the buses. Let's see here. You could also, maybe let's put a limit of how many cars is 30 meters? Calculator, 30 divided by 5, that's 6 cars. I think that's enough. So this is about 30 meters here, will be about like this. I think 30 meters will be my own sort of, just based on my experience, not really on any books, threshold is how close the entrance can be in the corner. Come on, zoom out. 30 meters is about, measure this distance from this to this. About here would be the closest I would want the entrance. About 5 car lengths. No, 6 car lengths. Because I'm averaging like a 5-meter sort of allowance for a car. So why did I choose 30 meters? You could put like 6 cars between that and that distance. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, something like that. And for me, I think 6 cars allowance is good enough, so it doesn't really cause a lot of traffic. This guy can like turn around, no problem. The guy next to him can follow, no problem. And you have 1, 2, 3 cars who are like basically free moving and not really kind of, the 3 cars back here don't have to make the decision or like they don't have to be careful about the intersection yet, and they're just moving forward. As a driver, they're only thinking about moving forward and not the turn yet. So they'll be more quick to move forward. So that's why I choose 30 meters, if that makes sense. If there are like any drivers here, that's just my experience. It's like, if I'm the guy in here, the second guy behind this guy about to make a right turn, I'm already slowing down and I want to make sure that I don't hit the guy in front of me and like there's no one else coming behind. Okay, so really just putting yourselves in the minds of the users. That's what, for me, user experience design, or like a user, what do you call this? A more user-friendly design would be. Okay, so this scheme is also good, but not as efficient. I'll be curious if anyone can make this work. For me, the main issue here is like getting OpenSpace up here is not really fully utilized, and it'll be very sort of annoying to expand it or add future expansion. Like new roads here will be bad because it will intersect with the pedestrian traffic here, so you don't want that. Sort of another third option would be, let's see here. So again, I'll have my pedestrian entrance is like priority in this corner and maybe a little bit of this corner. Vehicle entrance would be here. Just with this data that you found out where you want your vehicle entrance and exits, you can really do a lot. So let's say I'll move my vehicle entrance a bit up here. So we had building, first scheme was the building was over here. Second scheme was the building over here. Third scheme, Natalie's scheme will be like building over here. Like this. But that would eliminate the entrance over here. So it's just same entrance, same exit for the buses. If you're in this situation, same entrance, same exit, I would maybe 90 degrees would be better. Because if you've angled it, it'll be difficult to go in and out. So your road will just be here. Very right, wide road. And then maybe your pedestrian entrance will be, instead of like near Bayfront, would be more over here. So they can access the terminal directly. They can access terminal directly. And then this will be open space over here. The benefit of this scheme is that you have sort of more of a buffer from the noise of the highway. And then maybe your expansion could go like this, could make an L shape. So you can just like expand the road like this. Maybe this road will also be like two-way because they'll park in here and then they'll still need to go out here. Okay. Which one is the best? For me, I'll stick with my one. What do you call this? I'll stick with my initial scheme. For some reason, my original idea is, what do you call this? The simplest or like the most effective one, mostly because I feel like I overthink things. It's just me. This is my experience as a designer, but like you can also like choose whatever. Because in this original design, I feel like a sort of like pocket garden is more useful than like a buffer garden, because more people will be hanging out here. Let me make a new layer. This will be quieter. More people will be like hanging out here, waiting for their bus. And then you can put more shops here. And this will really, because I have a sort of vendetta or ulterior motive of having more public space in Cebu. This one technically won't be public space because it's owned by the terminal. But really need more parks like this. And sort of like a segue to that, there is a, what do you call this? We were just recently informed of a public consultation for guidelines on the creation of use of parks and public open space for the promotion of physical and mental health and well-being during and after COVID-19 pandemic. So this just came out March 25, like basically a month ago. I don't know why we're only hearing about it now. It's almost like April, like it's just 2 weeks before April 25. So I don't know why this took so long. But anyway, this document, you could use this in your design as well, and we appreciate it if you use it. Outlines what a public park should be, or in our case, a semi-public park because it's owned by the bus terminal. Let's see here. What is public open spaces? What is blue, green, and urban spaces? Active spaces, passive open spaces, and general guidelines for like, let me zoom in. Where's the zoom in here? General guidelines for the public open space. Public open space shall remain operational and accessible to the public and in limited capacity when and as applicable. So this is more like for the operation of the park. Health and safety protocols, not so much there. That's just like COVID, standard COVID protocols. Risk-based classification, minimum standards for the creation and promotion, operation, use of healthy public open spaces. So again, look at this document. It starts out with open and accessible. So what does that mean? recognizing that public open spaces are essential to the core functioning of a community, all public open spaces shall be easily accessible by foot, priority, pedestrians, bicycle, and other forms of active or light modes of transportation. So we're moving slowly, it's happening in Cebu, we're moving away from vehicle or like a motorized vehicle design. So in communities where public open spaces are limited, similar to our area in SM, existing lands or recreational areas in schools and other similar properties may be opened up for the for such purposes through shared use agreements between relevant entity, what they call this, private entities and local government. So universal design, this is child, elderly, PWD, and pet-friendly public open space. So anyway, it goes on and on. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 guidelines on how to like design your public open space or park or like square. And this would be better for me because it's protected from the noise of the highway over here and it's closer to SM. Because my goal as a designer and like I think my goal forever until like I die is really to provide Cebu City with more public open space. So this is what I mean by providing your own sort of goal on top of the ones we listed here and sort of just aligning it and creating more value in the site. So I would, for me, this is just what I believe is the best scheme, but you can also have your own best scheme. So just, it's all about bringing forth your ideas and developing them and sort of bringing it back to the hotel plate. A lot of you had very good ideas. And the reason why you couldn't get the best score or like a high score is because you didn't integrate your ideas or concepts with the design. Like, for example, someone in the hospital plate said they wanted sustainable design, but it's not shown in the building. It's just green walls and that's it. That's very shallow. So sustainable design for me means that you're focusing more on pedestrians because like it's the mode of transportation that has the least CO2 footprint. You're not producing any CO2 gases. You're producing way less compared to cars if you walk or you bicycle. So your design should be built around accessibility for people walking and cycling. And then secondary will be the vehicles. And that's even important in the bus terminal design. Like it's still a bus terminal, it's in the name, but the who will be using the bus terminal? It's the people. So really focus more on the people, like the pedestrians, other modes of transportation. We talked about the private vehicles, taxis, jeepneys, and buses, but we didn't talk about the walking. How will we like access the bus terminal by walking, and how will we access the bus terminal by cycling? So maybe you'll put some bicycle racks. That's why I highlighted in like my presentation earlier that over here, this area here, I just highlighted with the measurement tool. This area here, I measure distance. This has like bike racks. And unfortunately, there's very few actual bicycles using the bike racks because SM City itself, from the roads and around the parking areas, the access points, there's really no sort of bicycle lane. So that's an additional thing that you could add to your terminal design, bicycle lane. Okay, it's already 11:02, and I think I already talked about the general concepts of the bus terminal design. And anyone else with their own sort of terminal like questions, feel free to drop, share your screen or whatever. So yeah, stop presenting. And so Natalie got most of the attention, so I'll be.